directo con Lindsay Fonseca.
Un aplauso.
Un aplauso bien bonito ahí para Lindsay.
So, Lindsay, let's talk about when you started. I read that you, when you started pretty early on in your career, I think you had your first break around 12 or 13 years old.
My first job was Young and the Restless at 14.
And I also read that you have a backup in dancing. So you started first as a dancer?
Yeah, I grew up dancing. I still tap dance, but I gave up my pointe shoes a long time ago. And I grew up dancing, and then I started acting, and then I didn't think that I was going to use my dancing skills for anything until Nikita, when we did all the martial arts. It really paid off to have the dance background.
So in the Young and the Restless, how many years, how long did you were in that?
I spent 4 years.
4 years.
So I spent my high schooling on the school.
Oh, really?
Program.
And you're originally from, I think, Oakland, California?
Yeah.
And
which I think was just labeled the most dangerous city in the world or something recently.
You've always lived there, or did you have to move like for acting?
I moved from San Francisco to Los Angeles.
I mean, this is a personal question. Did you know the ending, like, at the start? Or was it something that it developed throughout the years?
Are there
How I Met
Your Mother fans here? When I got How I Met Your Mother, David Henry, who plays my brother, he was 14, and so he went through this growth spurt from the pilot to shooting the first season, and he grew like 4 shoe sizes, and he just like his voice dropped, and it was crazy. And so the creators realized, holy crap, he's gonna grow, and we're supposed to be in the same time, you know, on the couch. So we spent 2 days filming wild lines that were unrelated to anything. The writers were prepared to use the footage.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you that. How long, like each season, did you like film the lines and record it, you know, for the show? Because it's a long time.
We did it once.
So for nine years,
that was one time. Except for San Diego Comic-Con, we did our own little spoof. How I Met Your Mother creators wanted us to come back and do something specifically for the Comic-Con. But we knew the ending all along, and they had lawyers come onto set, and we had to sign.
Everyone would definitely fuck his brains out if I got the chance.
So we didn't know how long the show would last. We didn't know if it was going to be 1 year. Yeah. We didn't know if it was going to be 12 years. So we just knew, all right, we have this information, and we shot it, and they, you know, had all this footage that they used over the years.
That's incredible. Did you knew from the start the whole ending? And did you tell anybody in your inner circle, your parents?
I swear I didn't even tell my mother.
Nobody.
And it's weird because when you don't tell a secret for so long, you forget it. And I swear I forgot. I swear. When the show was coming to an end, David and I were like, wait, what did they say? Because it was in Talk of the Town, everyone wanted to know it was coming to an end. And it took me a bit to remember because it had been so many years and I didn't tell a soul.
And as a fan, were you satisfied by the ending? I mean, being involved in everything, but as a fan, were you involved, like, were you satisfied how they ended the whole thing?
I was satisfied.
You guys satisfied with the ending? How about your mother?
No, I don't.
Okay. It's not her fault. Don't worry about it.
It's not my fault. A lot of people were not satisfied. Yeah. I didn't know what to do.
But I know something that you guys were satisfied. Let's talk about Kick-Ass.
Yeah, I was very intimidated. I went in and auditioned with a lot of other people and just did it regular like everybody else. And I actually was cast. I might have been the first cast, even one of the first, because I had chemistry reads with before Aaron was cast as Kick-Ass. So I read with a few other actors, and it just timing-wise happened that way. It wasn't like they chose to hire me.
Can you tell us any other actors that were in the competition, you know, for the?
No.
Do you prefer, as a fan, more of the kind of like violent, dark, serious stuff, or would you say you're more in tone with the action and the tone of Agent Carter and stuff like that?
Well, shooting Agent Carter was great because I had just come off of Nikita doing all this action and playing a spy and doing all the martial arts, and then going to a show like Agent Carter where Hayley Atwell did all that and I just, you know, played the waitress was a great switch for me because I got to play the comedy. I got to just be a different person, and it was a great, awesome switch. I think there's places for both.
You can do both.
Kick-Ass was violent, but the first one was done in such a great way. I mean, Matthew Vaughn's such a great director that it wasn't gory or anything like that. It was done in a way that was like a comic book, so I enjoyed it.
Yeah, fans loved it. I know there's been rumors and rumblings. Can you tell us anything related? Maybe we're going to see possibly a case of Kick-Ass 3?
There is not one that I am aware of.
Okay. No, maybe we can start that here in Puerto Rico Comic Con this year. And if it's a possibility, would you be interested in being a part of it?
Okay. Absolutely. When Kick-Ass 2 started, I was shooting Nikita in Toronto, and I couldn't be in Kick-Ass 2 more than one scene. I basically flew for one day and had to fly back, and it was just a scheduling issue, so that's kind of why I wasn't in it much. So if there was a third one, I would love to be part of it, but it's not really a...
Let's get it started. Let's start a rumor here in Comic-Con. Let's go online. So let's jump to Nikita. I know that Nikita was a more physical role. Can you talk to us about your preparation, your training to get into the role?
Sure, yeah. I mean, I learned on the job. Like, there was no martial arts training, and before I got cast and I was thrown into it. So obviously Maggie Q is a, you know, very veteran of martial arts, so I had someone to watch and learn from. We had an incredible choreographer. I did all of my own fighting. The only stunt work that I didn't do were things like jumping off of a moving car, or, you know, certain things that, like,
not safe.
You know, they wouldn't even let me do if I wanted to do. But all the fighting, and our stunt doubles were very important, because they would try out the space, they would learn it for it first, and then teach us. So, like, even though I didn't, you know, all my own fighting or doubles were very important. But yeah, it was crazy. I just, like, all of a sudden was doing martial arts, and I was like, oh.
And let's jump to then you doing what we talked about, like, Agent Carter. You guys fans of Agent Carter? Yeah? So, can you talk to us a little bit about participating in the show?
Haley's amazing. Haley is...
looks like a lot of fun.
She's one of my favorite people to work with ever. And Marvel, you know, the people behind Agent Carter were all the feature film side of Marvel. So it wasn't the television department, yeah, like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. and other shows. So it was very intimidating, because, like, the head of Marvel...
Yeah, working very, very close.
And the directors, you know, Joe Russo, who did one in Captain America, I mean, his directors were big time. So I was very intimidated. And the quality of the show is just so incredible. It's the writing, the way they shoot. So it was like shooting a movie, but it was a TV show. And Haley is just the most loving and welcoming. I enjoyed the small job, you know, coming off Nikita and having so much to do. I enjoyed just showing up on set and getting to hang out with her.
Yeah, that's pressure. You're like,
it was awesome.
Is there any character, it could be Marvel, DC, or whatever, any character, any comic book character, superhero, that hasn't been done that you would, you know, love to have that role and maybe do a film, maybe you're approached or, you know, start a campaign? Also, that you a role that you would like a superhero, a comic book, now that, you know, it's dominating the box office and everything.
Well, I think that there should be more females.
Definitely.
Yes, definitely. The very few we have are surrounded by men, which men are great, don't get me wrong. I love men.
why don't
we have the Avengers with all females? I mean,
that's a pretty cool idea. You can just start the promotion, and you can be like the captain of the group. And
yeah, but
that would be awesome. What kind of superpower are we talking about? That's gonna be your thing.
It's
a movie that's gonna happen. It's already on IMDb. You guys can check it out. What kind of superhero power you'd always love to have? It doesn't matter. You can tell us if it's flying. If it's already done, but it's gonna be yours.
Can I stop?
Being stop what?
Just stop all animal cruelty.
That's a global one. Yeah.
What are your favorite?
Yeah. What do you guys think
your
superpower should be? Telekinesis?
Telekinesis, ooh, I like that. That's
cool. Teleporting right here. What?
gravity manipulation.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool.
That's physics.
Time travel?
Time travel. I'm shooting a time travel movie at this moment, actually. It just flew in.
I was going to ask you that. Yeah, let's segue to that. Is there any projects that you're working right now that are going to come out on TV or a film?
I'm shooting a movie right now called Curvature, and it's done by two Spaniards, brothers, director and producer, the Halavis brothers, and they're incredible filmmakers. And I'm playing the lead of a woman who lost her husband, and it's kind of a psychological thriller. And then time travel is involved, and it's a really great mystery time travel movie. And I had to learn a lot about time travel, which I'm sure you guys know a lot about because of, you know, Marvel movies and stuff. But wow, I had quite the physics lesson.
Yeah, it's pretty confusing.
Yeah, and there's different theories, you know, there's different
process.
But we stuck to one time travel theory, and it's been really
What's the film? What's the title of it?
It's called Curvature.
Curvature. And when can we expect that to hit the
I have no idea. I'm still shooting it right now.
And anything else? Any TV shows or any... I want to ask you, you've been a long time in the business since you were young. Is there at any point interest in maybe directing, writing, doing something else besides acting?
Yeah, I think as I get older, like I'm sure you've heard other actors say that you just want to be in charge of more, you know? You don't want to just sit by the phone waiting for it to ring. So I have a partner and we've been getting book rights and trying to produce. And there's stories that I definitely want to tell that aren't being told. So that's definitely in my future.
And before we go to the Q&A, I wanted to ask you some, so people like your, what kind of style, your likes and dislikes. Can you tell us, growing up, what kind of movies impacted you or TV shows that you grew up and you love? Like, I don't know, Star Wars or Jaws or anything that people can get to know you a little bit? Like,
I was obsessed with E.T.
E.T.?
Yeah.
Being an E.T. fan?
Cool.
E.T. What else?
My little sister looked exactly like Drew Barrymore in that movie. It was so weird. We always called her Drew Barrymore. And I loved the whole black and whites. I love Audrey Hepburn movies and Katharine Hepburn movies. And I loved I Love Lucy. I loved all the kind of Nick at Night. I like those old Carol Burnett. Do you guys know who she is?
Yes.
Like, love that stuff. Kind of the old variety stuff.
Going into Nikita, did you know Alex's background story, or did that come along with the series?
Both. I knew a lot beforehand, and then some stuff kind of they created all along the way. I mean, when I got the part, I knew very little about Russia or the Ukraine, so I actually went to the library to figure it out, and there was also a lot of dark past to Alex, and so, like, human trafficking and, you know, very sad stuff that I had to kind of research and learn about. So there was a lot that I knew, and then other stuff just kind of came along the way.
Thank you.
Guy at the library thought I was pretty
new. Hi, Lindsay.
Hi.
This question comes from a friend that couldn't be here today.
Okay.
Her name is Paula. She wanted to ask you, what's your best memory / moment that you have with the cast of How I Met Your Mother? I know it's a bit to the throwback, but you did have Emma. What's your best moment?
Oh, man. I mean, the cast is so nice. They're amazing. I was at a party for How I Met Your Mother, and Bob Saget, who's the voice of the father, we met and had a chat, and I grew up watching Full House, so that was really cool and weird for me.
It was almost like surreal.
Yeah, and I was so young when I started that, you know, Josh, who plays Ted, we're like, you know, the same age, kind of, and so I was like this little girl, and then he thinks it's weird that I play his daughter now, and so we joke about it all the time. It's very weird.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Hi. Hi. Welcome to Puerto Rico.
Thank you.
My question is, given that you're an actress and you've done a lot of things, I did watch The Keeper. I loved it. I loved your character.
Thank you.
And I do love Maggie Q, but since you do get opportunities to do different types of characters, would you prefer villains or heroes?
You know, I've never really played a villain. I would love to do that. Villains don't think they're villains.
But villains are the best ones.
Best one.
What?
Villains tend to be the best ones, though.
Yeah. Yeah, that would be awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This question comes from my friend that she couldn't be here either. So she was telling me, like, how was it like working in on Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.? Agent Carter.
It was wonderful. James Darcy and Hayley Atwell are these crazy Brits that are hilarious. The two of them are like a sitcom. They're just comedy all the time. They're jumping in trash cans and making themselves laugh on set. I mean, it's just ridiculous. They're so fun to work with.
Hi again.
Hello again.
I'm Javier. It's very nice to be here. I'm a huge fan of yours. You're one of my favorite actresses. I absolutely loved you in Kick-Ass and Agent Carter. And I just wanted to ask you, based on those experiences, would you like to maybe one day pursue a leading role, or I guess now a supervillain role in a superhero movie?
To do a villain in a movie?
Yeah, a supervillain or like a main antagonist or a leading role as a hero?
Absolutely, but like I said, we need more women in film.
Absolutely, I completely agree. And I believe an actress like you, who has the chops, the acting chops, the looks, I mean, totally.
Thank you. Yeah, that's the dream, right? We need more writers and production companies to make them. Yeah, I agree with you. Thank you.
I'm rooting for you.
Appreciate it.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hi.
I have a question. So, since you started very young, your acting career, how was your training in acting to become professional actress like today? Like, did you take classes? How's your process for every character?
Like a lot of people, you know, go to college for it and learn it in school, and I kind of just started so young. I learned on the job. Young and the Restless was a great training ground because there was so much dialogue. It was very fast paced. It was low stakes, you know, it wasn't as big of an audience, so it was like I could really learn. So that was a huge training ground for me. And then when I went to, you know, primetime TV and stuff, I started working with a coach, and that's about it. I mean, I really just learned from other actors. Kind of like learning on the job, I think. No formal training.
Hi, Lindsay. My name is Eugene.
Hi.
Thank you for being here. My question for you is, has superhero movies or anime movies inspired you to be an actress? Or what made you inspired to be an actress?
I think it just was like, it was like breathing air. Like, some people do it for different reasons, and for me, it's like, if I don't have the emotional output, I don't know what would happen. I think it's crazy. So it's acting. Is just that I physically, like, I need it to emote. So when, you know, growing up, I didn't think I could do it as a living. I mean, that seems like a crazy dream, but then it happened. It was like the heavens opened up, and it was amazing.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
My name's Sophia, and I was wondering, like, since you started acting so young, like, why did you decide to do it? Like, did you do school plays and stuff like that?
No, I never did a school play because I started in school. I was working at 14 full time. Actually, I learned about plays very late in the game when I started to go to New York and have actors, friends that were on Broadway and stuff. So I fell in love with theater much later because I grew up on TV. So I kind of did it backwards, I guess. I think there's just this drive in you. You know, you guys probably do things you love doing. You're here because you're passionate about something, right? So it's the same, just super passionate about something, and I really like the challenge of meeting people. And I mean, it's just expressing yourself. Yeah.
Thank you.
Was there a moment when you were, because you started as a dancer, was there a moment in particular that you remember that you were like, acting, I need to do this. Just forget about dancing right now. Acting, how did you, is there a moment you don't want to talk about that you were like, I need to do this for a living, this is what I want to do for the rest of my life?
Before I end The Restless, I did a chocolate commercial.
There we go. Chocolate.
It always comes back to chocolate. I did a chocolate commercial, and it was the first time I'd ever been on camera, and I said, I'm doing this for the rest of my life.
Every time the issue of female representation in Hollywood comes up, like the people in charge say, we're working on it, we're making things better. And I want to ask you from your point of view, your perspective as an actress, do you feel they're actually working on it from the perspective of the work you're getting, the production you're working, the ways, you know, everything is being done right now, do you feel they're working on it? Is something being done from your perspective?
Sure. I mean, look at Agent Carter, female lead. I definitely think, and you know, that's the head of Marvel saying, hey, that's Haley's character in this movie. Let's make her her own show. Give her a chance. So there are people that are working on it for sure. I think the problem is on behind the camera, is that you want more women directors and producers. So it's still a battle, but I think that it's going in the right direction. Thank you.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hi.
Huge fan. My question for you is, what was it like for you to play Alexandra Yudinov in Nikita?
Oh, she was a mess. It was awesome. Alex on Nikita kept me very busy. There was always, she was always getting into some trouble and needing to do something. It was so fulfilling because there was a lot to work with. Show. I really enjoyed it.
Thank you.
I miss her.
I can't imagine doing like research and, on her and getting background to prepare for the role.
Yeah, learn a lot.
Hello, Heriberto.
Hi.
Bienvenida. Un honor. Thank you. You finally directed your own movie. What style will you go for? Action, comedy, horror?
I think the combination of drama and comedy is my favorite. When dark comedy, you know, like sometimes you need humor to really feel the drama the most. So those are usually my favorite dark comedies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, Lindsay.
Hi.
How are you? My question is, how do you feel about Agent Carter's cancellation?
I think it sucks. Haley and I just emailed. She's shooting another show right now, so she's very busy. But I feel sad because I think the show was something that television doesn't have right now. I think it was a whole other level of TV, and I feel sad that the audience doesn't have that anymore because it was a really top notch.
See more than the future, yeah.
How are you?
Hi.
My question is also the character. How was your reaction to the cancellation?
My reaction to the cancellation?
He wants pretty much the same question about your reaction to the cancellation of the Agent Carter. Can we maybe do
a face reaction? Maybe? It could be different.
Face reaction?
Yeah, what was your face? There you go. Yeah.
That's about it.
We need to make that create a GIF of that right there.
Hi again.
Hi.
So you know you recorded the ending to How I Met Your Mother back with David Henry back on season 2. How hard was it to keep it a secret all those years?
It was hard at first, but like I said before, so long had passed that I forgot. It wasn't until the last season and all the fans knew it was going to come to an end, that's when all of a sudden I was like, oh, I forgot, I have a secret.
Hi. My question is, are you interested in voice acting, or if so, are you working on some cartoon show?
I would love to do some of that, absolutely.
If you're more interested, what kind of... What would you most interested in our consumer or that?
Maybe a Pixar movie, film,
yeah.
Something like that, or maybe that'd be cool.
Absolutely, yeah. There's some really great animation for adults on television. I would love to do that.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
You're talking about like a hardcore, like funny comedy, you know?
Yeah.
Cartoons, like.
Yeah, like Archer. There's things. Yeah. That'd be cool.
That'd be cool. Yeah.
Great.
didn't see. My question is, you talk about a series of time traveling. What era do you like to perform or dress? Could be in the future, could be in the past. You already presented the 40s in Into the Field, in the quarter. I want to know what kind of era do you want to perform?
Era.
Yeah, if you do like a time travel like in the film you talked about.
Yeah. Well, on Agent Carter, it was so fun to be in the 40s. That was like a dream. So fun. I would love to do the future soon. I mean, the film I'm shooting right now isn't a futuristic time travel movie, but there is a future me of my character. And so that's a really cool thing to play with, is two versions of yourself.
Hi, Lindsay. So my question is, when you were on Nikita, was it difficult, the language barriers, when you had to speak German or any other language?
Yeah, so I had a Russian tutor for when I spoke Russian on the show, and it was really challenging, but it was really fun. I learned the dialect. I didn't learn the language like you would learn it in school, like what words mean. I learned it like a song to be able to pronounce it perfectly so that someone who speaks Russian would think that it was good. Because I didn't have time to learn another language. I mean, it would take me 10 years to learn Russian well. So I would learn it like a notes to a song so that when I spoke it, it sounded authentic. It was very hard.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Another question. Star Wars or Star Trek?
Oh gosh, now you're gonna make me enemies to some people. I can't do that here,
this
man.
Star Wars, that's not a Star Trek.
Yeah. Oh god. Well, what's the room say?
That's a trap.
Wait. Star Wars? Star Trek. Star Wars. Shows, so, and the audience is different, you know, you don't have to get commercials, you know, to pay for your show is different, so I think that would be amazing.
I want to ask you, after all your experiences in Nikita and your cover and stuff like that, have you had any bad experiences with the cast or something? Was it always a friendly environment, or was there somebody that you didn't get along with?
No, it's not always fun, and no, you don't always get along with everybody. You know, it's like any job, you can't...
Anybody specific or...
I can't tell you! Let's just say I've had great people like Haley, and I've had... Aaron Johnson was a blast. I mean, I've had so many great people, but yeah, there have been challenges. And you know, it's very interesting because you learn how to navigate different people's personalities. There's a lot of great actors out there, and there's a lot of not so great actors out there. Sorry, I can't give you more specifics, but
it's okay. It's okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Lindsay.
Hello.
My question is on the series Nikita. You had a fight scene with Meg Q, right?
Yeah.
On a real fight, who do you think will win?
A fight between Nikita and Alex? Alex.
No, a real fight.
Oh, a real fight between Maggie and I?
Yeah.
Oh, goodness. Probably her. She has way more stamina than me. I hate cardio, so that girl could probably go for a day straight fighting, so she would.
Thank you. Hi, welcome to the island. My question for you is, if you could exchange your life for one of the characters that you've played by far, which character would it be? Like, if you could live their life for the rest of your life.
Wow, that's interesting. I've never really thought about that.
Nikita's pretty hardcore, so.
Yeah, I don't think I would like to really be Alex. That's exhausting. I don't know. I think that all of them have, like, a really cool part of them, though. The character I'm playing right now in my new movie is an engineer. She's a graphic engineer, and she works on designing satellites. And it's the first time I've played kind of like a scientist or someone that works with physics and stuff like that. And that has been really cool. I think my character in Curvature is much cooler than me.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello.
My question for you is, if you had a chance to go anywhere around the world to film a movie or series, where would it be and why?
Oh, goodness. Probably places I've never been. I've been to a lot of places for travel and work, but I've never been anywhere in Asia. I think that would be really fun to work there, and never been to Australia. I really like France, and I really like Italy. Italy's one of my favorite places.
You like Puerto Rico, right?
Obviously.
Yeah, <sorry. laughs> she will come to Puerto Rico.
Unlike some people, I do know that Puerto Rico is American, so I feel very at home. Very at home.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello?
Hello.
Who is your biggest inspiration and why?
Gosh, it's so cheesy, but my mother.
I thought you were going to say chocolate.
And chocolate. My mom, she's just been such a huge supporter and has taught me. She's a psychologist, and so she also is a great mom and then also has such great advice on life and how to navigate through it, and really lucky to have a great mom. So cheesy, I know. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, we got maybe time for one or two questions more. Anybody else want to ask her something? You guys sure? Oh, you got one. We got time for one or two more, so.
Hello.
Come up in there.
How you doing?
Good.
I wanted to ask you, what has been your most rock star moment since you've been in the business?
My most rock star moment?
Yeah, the funnest, wildest.
Wow. I was on a yacht in San Diego with the creator of Game of Thrones. That was pretty rock star.
That's pretty bizarre, too.
Yeah, I didn't know what he looked like, and I felt very silly for a while, but
and we talked. It's pretty cool. That was for San Diego Comic-Con at the Entertainment Weekly party, and I was nominated for a SAG Award with the cast of Desperate Housewives. So when I was there, I was with incredible people like Kate Winslet and Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie. That was kind of strange to be in a room with them. That felt pretty cool.
Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I kept thinking they were going to kick me out.
Here we go, last one. Yeah.
Hi, welcome to Puerto Rico.
Hi.
Just wanted to see what's your advice for aspiring actors since basically learned on the job. What was your take on that?
I would say stop putting yourself in a box. Just there is room for like every single type of person, and I'm so sick of like women my age having to deal with certain things. Playing certain roles, just create your own stuff. Like, we're in such an incredible time where you can put something on YouTube, you can create your own thing, you can just your own films. Do anything that is your own and don't wait for anybody to give you the opportunity, because nobody's going to be like, here, you gotta just do it your own thing. Make your own project. It will pay off.
Okay, guys, can we give a round of applause?
Thanks, guys.